Wrong. He's doing this all wrong.
Who would be the one so vile as to make you angry with what's happening on the Nile?
It's King Alexander. Not because of his decision to come here and build a city instead of continuing where he left off with Persia, but how he's planning to do it.
And who are you to say such?
I go by Dinocrates, practitioner of Dionysian architecture.
Ah, you're the one I'm looking for. The inventor of all those mechanical devices the soldiers have been playing with for the past few days.
Indeed I am. Amusing little devices, aren't they?
Too much. They're so popular that the soldiers are asking for more recreational time to play with them. Pretty soon they'll be asking for bread, a circus, dental plans, of course Clytus does need braces, and work privileges to access that fangled bulletin board you put in the middle of the camp. The one where they post what they're thinking and doing like a bunch of twittering songbirds.
You don't like Chirpa?
I'd rather keep my face in my own private space.
Huh. Interesting. You know, I like you, stranger.
And I am tenuously impartial towards you.
Oh, well, at least it's not outright hatred. Let me tell you then, the city should actually be like a body. Now, a main thoroughfare must go here, while another road intersects here. Then you're gonna run it. Run into the issue of zoning. You can have high-income housing here near the industrial sector. Hey!
No?
Are you listening?
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. About zoning and other easily delegated administrative junk that I don't need to worry about.
Well, why did I hear snoring?
It's your ideas. They travel through my nostrils and the snore-like sound is my mind processing them.
I've never heard of this thought process.
Well, it's a rare genetic gift found in about one in whatever the estimated number of the people in the world is, not counting slaves and Philotas, obviously.
So in essence, only you.
Of course.
Anyway, if you want a functioning civil service department, budget
Good
must be part
of... Gaia, this man bores me. Could just walk away from this, of course, but that means his boredom has rule over me. If only there was a way to... What? What's going on now? Did I get invited into somebody's barrel again?
Well, whatever the case, at least the city turned out pretty well.
Hey, you!
Who are you to refer to me as such?
The local authorities, jackass! Did you see two thieves run by here?
Do not raise your tone upon me. Who do you think I am?
The prick who's covering up for them if that's your attitude. All right, punk. You have the right to remain silent.
Oh, there you go, Gamorandus, with that due process shit. Like Magnus and his wife Carter's idea about the ruler accountability. It ain't gonna catch on.
Oh, just you wait. It will.
Such whimsy the common folk think up. Allow me to critique them by using your hand to represent such ideas. To shove such humdrum drivel back at you.
Get him!
Run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the Alexander. Man, watch how I bob and evade you through my city, my legacy, a city I know from its lively beginning to its abrupt end.
Now we've got you.
Okay, Dinocrates, I found your little universe charming. Now it's time to stop this nonsense. This is your attempt to impress me. It's working rather well. Dinocrates?
Now, kangaroos. We should have 50-foot statues of them on the main shopping plaza.
Oh, by the pecking predicament of Prometheus?
See, it was wise to install the chime so we knew if somebody entered our lair. Follow us. So, you have become an involuntary victim for our high-risk business ventures. Our apologies, we tend to pick up a lot of unsuspecting rabble along the way. Let us introduce ourselves. I'm Eben, and this is ZariWari. As you can tell, we are
Cretans.
Eh?
You two.
Persians.
All's Greek to me, since all ends up being trampled under my foot. As much as I could shower gratitude and fascination on the two of you for what appeared to be my impending death. Let's just skip the icebreaking and get down and dirty. Well, you will, I won't, but you get the... Now, just tell me who you are and what you're doing.
Well, we're thieves searching for an entrance to the great King Alexander's mausoleum.
No way. I can die?
What?
Nothing. Carry on.
And in this chamber is a secret gem known to house all the knowledge of the abridged world, more so than the Great Library and more so than what progress has been made since the city was built 100 years ago. Like your eyewear, ZariWari.
This eyewear codec?
And
that's it.
You forgot one part, though.
And that is...
You satiate my curiosity by taking me to this tomb.
But we just met it. It's impossible to do, so...
Take me to it. Take me. Now. Hey, I'm reading this door. How the Zeus did Ptolemy become king?
What just happened?
The silent wind of destiny under my employ led you both to this destination. Question it not, you unwilling victims.
Well, I won't question, but I will comment that it stinks. I was kind of hoping to teach you about this brave new world.
Well, in some sight in time where length is not much of a bother than it could have been. Also, like a lot of people, I don't like the future being spoiled for me. So tag that for your sake. Also, I'm not the stinky one you are.
Look, it's the Great King's tomb!
Stranger, don't!
We.
Ah, my king!
You look rather... well, Master Aristotle. What are you doing?
Oh, transcending death, becoming what's called a... force ghost. Been waiting 100 years to give you a message, but now I can't remember what it was.
Aren't ghosts renowned for holding on to certain ideas? Grudges or what have you?
You'd think that, but clearly it isn't the case. In the meanwhile, I've been searching for the next evolutionary form of a sandwich Plato once gave me. It's a sausage patty, but instead of 2 full moon bread halves, it's 2 crescent moon.
Oh, I see you're interested in the Platohedron. Well, feel free to take it.
That's it? You're not going to stop me?
Yes, but I know you. When I say no, you say yes. So I decided not to really exacerbate the situation and just give it to you.
Well... no, I don't want it then.
I'm letting you take it!
And I don't want to. What point is there for me to do anything if I can't trample somebody who thinks otherwise of my acts?
Do it!
No.
Release the seal!
No.
Yes!
No.
Yes!
No.
Yes!
Yes.
No!
I shall open the seal!
No! I mean...
Too late!
More than one bridge. Bridge in one world. Is there only one? Or many. Bridges. World. Live there. I'm saying what I can't say.
No, damn you. You. Fuck this, I'm gonna go make that sandwich myself.
What in great Zartoth's name was that?
More likely a sign of our impending death. Told you we should have opted for something more kosher, like that arc.
Not if I have anything to say about it. Come along, you crazy kids.
Well, that was a journey most bogus.
Hey, there they are!
Ah, back to our old daily constitutional. Again. Farewell to you then, stranger, and good luck.
Hello! Stranger, are you with me? Hey, that deep snore-like sound better be like a processing more thoughts than before.
Huh? Oh, yes. Oh, yes, very much so.
Okay, then tell me why I chose kangaroos to adorn the main shopping plaza.
It is to show testament to the great glory of Alexander and his city. A city of your design, filled with faces like Eben and ZariWari.
The Zeus, are they?
Why, people that are part of the very thoughts I have processed greatly.
I know no people of those names. Were you sleeping? You're as dulled in vision as Alexander if you did.
Of course not. But if it was neither dream nor barrel, then... what ambrosia was I hopped up on?
Well, work me on a sex farm and lick my love pump. It's the king!
Oh, thanks, Zeus. Now I won't have to think about what I went through anymore.
We've been looking everywhere for you, sire. A messenger from the High Priest of Egypt wishes to see you. We must return with great haste.
You're the king!
Yeah. He's the king. Didn't you know?
As a matter of fact, no. It's not like his face is emblazoned all over the camps like he had some cult or something.
A religion following me.
Even more kinky. I shall look into that when I get back.
No, don't leave me. I'm sorry, King Alexander. Please don't kill me. I was blowing off steam. I don't want to be punished.
Too bad, Dinocrates. You are punished. I sentence you with the task of building the city of your dreams. Let it shine upon this land. This I command. Hiya!
Yes, sire.
And Dinocrates.
Yes?
A 50-foot poodle greeting people into the city. That's just being silly. Make it a giant river otter instead.
What?
I love you. I love you.